Now, here's meteorologist Pete Mangione with your live Pinpoint Doppler 12 futurecast.
All right, good morning, everybody. I want to start with a picture from Lincoln, Rhode Island, and this was actually sent to Catherine, my co-anchor first. So, Catherine, why don't you describe what exactly this viewer does with his dog in terms of the snow?
Well, apparently, Pete, he takes that dog and he puts it in the snow to measure how much snow he gets. Isn't that unreal?
That's a very interesting technique, and it looks like the dog is a little bit annoyed.
Yeah. I mean,
the dog is saying, where is the snow? Exactly. It looks like he wants more. And we appreciate the picture from Scott. And basically, Lincoln, Rhode Island, not getting a whole lot of snow, so that's why this dog looks a little disappointed. Let's see where the snow did fall. Again, that picture coming from Lincoln, 2 to 5 inches there. Not a whole lot. I mean, a decent snow, but nothing really that extraordinary. 5 to 8 for places like Warwick, Cranston, Providence, actually. A report from Federal Hill, only 4 inches, so maybe this number should be 4. And then our jackpot was 8 to 12. From sections of South County, Newport, Little Compton, all the way into southeastern Massachusetts. A lot of snow coming down there. Basically, the storm dived a little further down to the south than I anticipated, leading to these higher snow totals. When those storms get in that certain position, often it can lead to very heavy snows along the south shore. Normally, we're used to seeing the heavier snows in northwestern Rhode Island, but not this time. In Providence, we have a little bit of increase in cloud cover. Temperature is 14 degrees. That wind chill still very chilly at 4 degrees, so wear the jacket, hats, gloves. If you're out there this morning, winds are out of the north at 7 miles an hour. 14 right now in Taunton, 17 Fall River, 16 in Newport, 15 Coventry, 14 in Gloucester, and 16 your current temperature in Westerly. All right, the satellite picture showing those clouds kind of scraping against eastern Massachusetts, now advancing into Rhode Island. I do expect this to sort of continue off and on for today as moisture, a little bit of moisture, continues to creep towards our sky. So we'll call it partly sunny throughout the day and then mostly cloudy by late afternoon. But it will be dry, so if you're headed to the game, that is good news as high pressure remains in control. 31 your temperature in Pawtucket today, 31 Rumford, 31 on the east side, and 31 for North Providence. Across the West Bay, we're looking good today, a little on the chilly side. Now keep in mind, all these numbers that you're seeing right here for high temperatures, these will only be met very briefly. In fact, some of these locations may be a little bit optimistic. I mean, the majority of the day will be spent in the 20s, and right now we're not even to the 20s yet. 31 in Wickford, 33 Charlestown, 32 Westerly, 31 in Coventry. For Northern Rhode Island temperatures, highs right around 30, maybe some spots staying stuck in the 20s for most of the day. A bit of a breeze, 5 to 10 miles an hour, nothing that windy, but certainly windy enough to put a chill in the air if you're out there, especially early. Eastern Massachusetts, this is where we already have a lot of clouds, and I expect them to sort of thicken up. That will be the general trend as we go into the afternoon and evening. So partly to mostly cloudy, we'll call it, for the Pats game. Dry, 30 at kickoff. Actually, those increasing clouds will actually keep temperatures up once that sun sets. So the game ending temperature around 6:30, I'm forecasting around 29 degrees. Not a big change, so not nearly as cold as last weekend, but certainly bring along the winter clothing. After all, it's a night game in January. This is the playoffs. We're tough. We can handle it. A little bit of freezing rain possible very late tonight through early tomorrow morning, but that looks like only about maybe a 10-20% chance of happening. Chance of some showers tomorrow, but that would be in the evening, so most of your Monday is actually dry, upper 40s. Tuesday starts off mild in the 50s. Maybe some rain and snow next week into next weekend. Of course, that's many days out, so stay tuned to future changes. But a great picture from Scott this morning.
Yeah.
That's a very unique snow measuring technique.
I know. Unbelievable. All right. Time for a check of what's happening over.